boop, boop.
DJ
Mantic. She always ride with the top down, even when it's cold outside.
Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a long and overdue video. This is going to be my everyday makeup tutorial. I get asked all the time about how I do my makeup, and I personally think my makeup is very basic. I usually never switch up my looks. I don't wear any eyeshadow. So I'm like, why do girls want to know my makeup look if it's so basic? But I'm gonna give y'all what y'all been asking for. Stay tuned if you want to see my everyday makeup look. This is my no makeup makeup look, girl. This is my glam makeup look. It's just one makeup look for everything. Weddings, birthdays, graduations, church, same look. But stay tuned. All right, y'all, so it's time to get started. The first thing I do when I do my makeup looks is my brows. So I'm gonna use my Precisely My Brow Pencil. I like to use the shade number 5. That is my perfect shade in my opinion. I like that one side, it comes with the product, and then the other side is the spoolie brush. So I take the spoolie first and brush out my brows. And if you see me looking down, I have my mirror right here. So I'm just trying to look there to make sure I'm doing everything right. Y'all, my lashes are just all over the place. I'm gonna go this week to get another fill because I like my lashes full, sis. Anyways, let's start off with the brows. I have to focus, so I'm not gonna be able to talk for this portion of the video, but just watch, sis. So I underline first under the brow, and then I go on top. And then I go in and fill it in. I try to go in lightly, not too heavy, because it can get really dark and look really harsh very quickly. And we don't want that. We want it to look natural, but then we still want it to look like you tried on brows. You know what I'm saying? Does that make sense? Then when I get towards the front, I like to just use strokes like this, like hair, like strokes at the front. And then I use my spoolie again to brush it out, because I don't like when the front of my brows look too harsh. Don't like it at all. And I don't like when brows look very boxy in the front. That doesn't look natural at all. So this is our first brow. Now let's move on to the second brow. So this is how our brows look so far. I think that looks good. And now we're gonna go ahead and shape them with our concealer. So I like to use the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Fawn. I've been using this concealer for years. It just does the trick. If it's not broke, don't try to fix it. You can always try new ones, but never get rid of the oldies but goodies. Especially because it's so affordable. It's like $5 for this concealer. So why not? And they have so many shades. So then I'm just gonna take my Morphe. This is the Morphe M410 brush. And then I'm just going to go in and line under my brow. It It's so funny now when I think about it because y'all, I used to love thick eyebrows. Like, thick eyebrows was my thing in college. And now when I look back at my college photos, I'm like, sis, what the hell were you thinking? Those brows was too big. But I just laugh at it and I can see the growth that I made with my makeup. But yeah, now I like them to look natural and thinner. Not super thin, but more of a, you know, natural like thin. So what I do, instead of using concealer at the top of my brows, I like to go in with my foundation. This is in the shade 520 Warm. So I pump a small amount of that on the top. I already wiped off my brush, and then I just go in and shape the top of my brow. And then that's what I do for my brows. Brows, I really be focused because I feel like brows just shape the face. Once your brows are good, the rest of your makeup is just gonna fall into place. Just my opinion. Right, boom. So these are our brows. So now I'm gonna go in and take my brush. This is a Morphe brush, but the numbers rubbed off, so I don't know the numbers, but it's just a fluffy brush, and I like to blend out the top first. So that's the top blended out, and then I'm going to blend out the bottom. And that's how it looks when it's all blended out. Then I just go in one more time with my spoolie in the front of my brows. And that's that. So these are how my eyebrows look. But anyway, moving on to skin, I'm gonna use my Too Faced Hangover Primer. I love this because it's made with coconut water, so it smells so good. It's very cooling on the face, and it works. It works for me. I like Too Faced products. So I take a small amount on my hands like this and just rub it in and then go into the skin. Another thing is I really don't wear primer like that every day, but I'm gonna put it on today for you all because when I do use primer, that's the primer I use. All right. Then I take my beauty blender along with my foundation and I go in and blend. I like to just blot it around the face. I like more of a medium coverage look when it comes to foundation. I just know I like for my skin to look more natural. Like, I like when you can kind of see through the foundation a little bit. That's me personally. A lot of people like that very full coverage type of look, and I don't. But if you do, just try to find a nice full coverage foundation, or just use layers, like layer up your product so when you're using it, if that's what you like. So back to our LA Pro Concealer. I'm just going to squeeze a small amount of that out, and then I'm going to put it under the eye. I put a few swipes, and then I put a few swipes over here. I also like to do in between my eyebrows and then a small amount on my chin. And then I just let it sit for a minute. I like when my concealer sits because it gets to be more full coverage. I don't know if that's just a mental thing or if it's really true, but that's just what I do. So I sit here for maybe like 30 seconds, let it dry up a little bit, and then go in and blend it out. So yeah, but back to it. So now I have my sponge. I'm gonna go in and blend it out. And I like to look up and blend. I like to get as close to the lash line as I possibly can without getting the product into my eyes. So. Okay, ladies, I have a serious question for my ladies that do makeup. Why do we make faces when we blend out our concealer? And especially when we do mascara, y'all, my mouth be like wide open and I never realize it until like later on. But you'll see, as soon as I do my mascara, you'll see, and it's not on purpose. It just naturally happens. So now going into my shape tape, this is in the shade 10 Deep Sand. A small amount of this, and I like to put it underneath my eye. And this is an even brighter concealer than the last one, just to give my under eye that extra brightness that I like. A lot of people like to skip this step. If you do, that's totally fine. Now I've learned how to blend it out properly without getting that flashback when you take a picture with flash. So that's why I do it. Back in the day, when I just started doing makeup, the flashback was real. It was real, and it still is for some people, but me, I've learned how to do it now, so I'm just gonna blend. And this concealer, I don't drag down like the LA Pro. I keep it directly under the eye area. Okay, and after doing so, then I go in with my Laura Mercier. I like to use the shade Translucent. This is my all-time favorite powder. I've tried a lot of them, but I always go back to this one. So I dip it in there, blow off the excess, and then I just go in and set under that eye. Then what I'm gonna do is go in with another Morphe brush. I thought this was my MAC brush, but I have a MAC brush that looks like this. This is the Morphe M551, it looks like this, and I use it to, instead of sweeping away my powder, I like to pack it in my skin. Now I'm gonna take my brush and brush out my lashes. It's always a few lashes that don't want to get in order. Girl. Okay, so now I'm going to go in and bronze. I like to use my Morphe E3 brush. This is probably my favorite brush. I use that with the Morphe bronzer and contour in one. Then I just go in and bronze. Look how pretty that is. I love this bronzer. Like, I've tried a few bronzers and I always go back to this one, and it's the cheapest one that I have. Like, I think it's like $11. And I'm a person that loves bronzer and loves blush, so sometimes I overdo it. I have to watch myself. And I go all around my hairline as well with this. hope y'all don't hear these kids that are outside playing because they don't need to be messing up my video. But I like to smile and put it right into my cheek area. I didn't do my edges on this side, so I'm gonna kind of turn a little bit so y'all can't really see. Y'all can't see my edges over here that's not slicked down. Okay. There we go. Mm-hmm. Then I'm gonna go back in with that brush that I used to blend out my concealer at the top, and I put a little bit of my bronzer on there, and I like to go in and just sweep that in my eye section just to give it some color in like my crease. And I do the same thing on this side. I guess this is considered eyeshadow, girl. I don't know. Then I also take this and I use it to contour my nose, even though I don't really contour. I just kind of bronze my nose. And then this is how it looks. So that's how we're looking. This is how the skin looks. Now we're gonna go in and bronze. So like I said, for bronzer, I'm using my Black Radiance Pressed Powder. This is in the shade Ebony. And then I take my Morphe E48 brush and I dip it into that product. And I put a small amount of that here. I like to smile, it helps define it more. Then I'm gonna go in with my blush, which is MAC, I believe, Burnt Pepper. Dip it into the product and then smile again. And I like to bring my blush up. I don't like to sweep it across and I don't like to just focus it on the balls of your cheeks. I like to tap it up. So then after I do that, I'm gonna go back in with my foundation. And I like to define my cheeks. Most people use powder for this, but I like to use foundation because I've noticed with powder that it leaves like a white cast underneath your cheek, and I don't like the way that looks. So this just makes it look a little bit more natural when you use your foundation. Even concealer, you can use concealer, but make sure it's your shade. If you use a shade lighter, then it's gonna look just like how the translucent powder would look with that cast look, and you don't want that. It's not cute like that. And then I blend it out. So this is how this side looks now. So I'm gonna show you this side with the cheek cut, and then this side without it. This gives more natural, not doing too much. This is a more defined look. I don't know if you can really tell the difference, but I can. And then I take my other side of my brush and I just go in and kind of blend all of these products in together. And then, sis, what we're going to do is put on some highlighter now. We're almost done with our makeup routine. Because at this point, your man is like, "Bae, hurry up. You taking too long." Or your girl's hitting you up like, "Sis, we supposed to be leaving now for brunch." So that's why we got to make it quick. Okay. So now I'm going to go in with my highlighter. And I just put it up in this area. Let me take a little bit more. I don't like to use too much highlighter, and then I don't use highlighter every day. So that's about all I use, and I just sweep it like this. And that's that. Nice subtle highlight. I don't like to do too much with my highlighter. And then I tap the nose. Perfect. Then go in with my bottom mascara. This is just the Wet n Wild Mega Length Mascara. And I'm going to do my bottom lashes. I don't do bottom lashes every day as well. Only when I'm in the mood, girl. Only when I'm in the mood. So now I'm going to put the bottom mascara on there. All right. So this is our bottom mascara on. And the last thing we need to do, sis, before we move on to lips is just our setting powder. I mean, girl, this is not setting powder. Setting spray. So this is the MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus. It used to come in different scents. Some of them have glitter, but I just stick with the classic. And just spray it on my face. The last step, which is my absolute favorite part of makeup. Like, I cannot do makeup and not kill my lips. Like, girl, lips make the look. So I like to use a brown lip liner. This is my absolute favorite lip liner from NYX. So I just take it and I'm going to line my lips. For the top lip, I like to overline the lip a little bit just so it gives me a little bit more fullness or a little bit more plump at the top. I was considering getting my lips done, but everyone's like, "You don't need to do it." And I'm like, girl, just a little bit. But until then, I'll stick with my lip liner. So now tell me that didn't just take your makeup look to a whole nother level. And we ain't even done yet. Just go ahead, I'll wait. Yeah. Yeah. Girl, lip liner is a must. I don't know. My makeup looks were not the ish without lip liner. Okay. Then after I do that, I like to take the NYX Butter Gloss. And this is in Fortune Cookie. This is basically empty. I don't know why I'm playing like it's something in this tube. Oh, hold on. We got a little bit. We got a little bit here. Take that. Oh, there we go. There we go. It felt so hot up. Hold up. Now that was too much. I got too excited. I'm gonna go back over that with some more lip liner. And then what's funny, I actually wipe off a small amount of my bottom liner because I don't like my bottom lip to look as full as my top lip. So I go in and wipe some away like that. Okay, boom. Then I go in with my Sephora lip gloss. This is the Outrageous, which is number one. It's such a pretty pink shade, but it doesn't come out with a lot of pigment. It's very like muted. So, put a small amount of that on the bottom and the top. And lastly, this is a must. I like my lips very glossy, and every woman knows that the beauty supply store Clear Lip Gloss is a hit, and it's only a dollar, sis. Go get you a few, okay? So this is the coconut oil lip gloss from the beauty supply store. And I just put a small amount of that on. The only other lip gloss that can get my lips super glossy, how I like them, other than the beauty supply store, is MAC lip glass. That one is the bomb, but it's sticky and it be spilling everywhere, so I just stick with this one. But yeah, girl, now you're ready to hit the streets with bae, or you ready to go out to brunch with your girls, or spend some quality time by yourself, sis, because you don't always need your friends or your man. Sometimes you just need to woos out by yourself. But anyway, this is the natural look. This look can be worn for any type of occasion. I hope you ladies enjoy my makeup look, and comment down below and let me know what other videos you would like to see. Let me know if this makeup look works for you as well, and if you have any questions about any of the products, about where to find them, just let me know. So thank you so much for watching, and until the next video. Bye.